the hell? Oh my gosh! Oh my, shut up! Shut up! Shut up! Shut up! Sup, though?
This is Martin Sixsmith, used to be the BBC's man in Moscow.
And Washington. You're depressed. Well, I got the sack. I'm unemployed.
Yes, but it wasn't your fault, was it?
That's why I'm depressed.
What are you working on at the moment?
I know this woman. She had a baby when she was a teenager. She's kept it secret for 50 years.
You're talking about a human interest story. That's... I don't do those.
Why not?
Cause.
You think I should do a human interest story?
No.
Philomena, how are you?
I had a hip replacement last year, Martin. Titanium, so it won't rust.
Otherwise I'd have to oil you like the Tin Man.
Is that right?
Oh, no.
He's just joking, Mum. I was going to ask if it would be possible not to use my real name when you write the story. What about Anne Boleyn? That's a lovely letter. What if somebody had that?
We're going to have to use your real name, Philomena.
I only want to know if he's all right.
Perhaps these older nuns should help us with some of the details.
I don't think that's going to be possible.
Why not?
You're a journalist.
I used to be.
Martin's a Roman Catholic.
Yes, well, no, I used to be. My guess is that Anthony was adopted and sent to America.
I think I would like to go.
She looks so pretty.
I'd like to know if Anthony ever thought of me.
No.
I've thought of him every day.
No, you haven't.
Should we go for a walk?
Or we could watch Big Mama's House. It's about a little black man pretending to be a fat black lady. It looked hilarious, Martin.
You told four people today that they were one in a million. What are the chances of that?
Oh. What if he died in Vietnam? Or lived on the street? Or what if he was obese?
That makes you think he'd be obese.
Because of the size of the portions. That's my Anthony.
I met him.
Where?
At the White House.
Dear God, what was he like? And did you remember anything he said?
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
It might have been hi.
Oh, Martin. I did
not. Oh, there it goes.
Child. He was taken from me.
She'd been looking for him. She spent her whole life trying to find him.
I've never been to Mexico, but I believe it's lovely.
No.
Apart from the kidnappings.
All right, judging by from what I just seen from this trailer, I'm just going off what I just seen from the trailer, is that you have this guy that's a journalist, right? You know, writes novels and stuff, and you have this woman, old ass woman, kind of creepy, I might add, and she has this son, which she had when she was a teenager, didn't specify how old she was, but, and I guess the son ran away or something, I'm guessing, and now she's on a hunt to go find him. But all I know is the son that she lost better not be this guy. If it is, I'm not seeing this movie in theaters though, but if it is, I'm going to be pissed. Because just don't do that. I really hope that's not it. But it looks like this movie looks like one of those date type movies. You know what I'm saying? It's not my signature phrase, but I will classify it as a date movie, or a movie for old people, I guess. I don't know. It's not my type of movie. If it's your type of movie, then by all means, watch the hell out of it. But, you know, that's just how I feel. Okay, wow, and I'm lagging. What the hell? But, yeah, so after watching this trailer, how you feeling right now, huh? How you feeling right now? Wherever you are in the world, wow. If you watch my video, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and good night. You say awesome.
What you twerking, man? Champagne, ain't no face, ain't no lame.
Bounce, 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 b